feel incredible. My whole body is tingling.
Yeah, it's seductive. But just remember what came out of the trunk of that Charger.
Yeah. You know, you never answered me from before. Why do you call him the Forsaken?
How much do you know about vampires?
Saul Coppola's Dracula?
No, the whole Vlad the Impaler story is horseshit. The real deal started at the Siege of Antioch during the Great Crusade. The first battle was a bloodbath. The Turks kicked ass, leaving 200 French knights dead or dying in a raging blizzard. By nightfall, there was only 9 of them still alive. That's when a bandit appeared before him.
Who's that?
The angel from the bottomless pit. In medieval legend, he appeared after battles, all dressed in black armor, looking for souls to steal. Now, the story goes that 8 of these French knights made a pact with a demon for eternal life. To seal the deal, they killed and drank the blood of the 9th one who had refused. But when the sun came up, they were so ashamed of what they had done, they couldn't stand the sight of each other. So they went and hid in caves until nightfall. They then went their separate ways, spread out all across the world alone, forever cursed with the desire for human blood and unable to ever again walk in daylight. The curse gradually became known as a disease, and as it spread, people started calling them the Forsaken.
The 8, are they still kicking?
About 300 years later, the first one was hunted down and killed in the Spanish Inquisition. But before the Grand Inquisitor whacked him, he spilt the whole story.
The others?
Over the past 500 years, 3 more have been hunted down and killed. Now we got 4 left. One's in Africa, 1 in Eastern Europe, and we know of 2 right here in the United States of America. Our boy being one of them.
I don't know, I get it. If we waste this guy, how does that cure us?
I told you, the virus is telegenetic. The strains are linked to the original 8. The last one was killed in Paris, 1967. He had 2 feeders with him who hadn't turned yet. Both of them recovered with no signs of the virus in their blood.